Hello, I am Hilda Glitz. You might know me as Chloe Bourgeois from the 86th Floor cosplay music videos and from the Cosplayers React to Miraculous Ladybug series. Today, I am going to be showing you how I do my utterly ridiculous Chloe Bourgeois cosplay makeup. Before we get started, just want to remind you to subscribe to our channel if you haven't. We make lots of content about cosplay, Miraculous Ladybug, and other topics as well, so hit that subscribe button and hit the bell so that you get notified. Loads of you guys requested this video, so I really hope you enjoy it. So, this is me completely out of cosplay, ready to get into cosplay. I'm wearing no makeup, so please forgive. So the first thing we're gonna start with is we're gonna put my hair up in a wig cap. This is just a kind of regular mesh wig cap that mostly comes with a wig. Like if you've bought a wig online, chances are you've got one of these. If you don't have one of these, honestly, just take a pair of like really thin tights, cut the legs off, and then pop that on your head instead. So here we go, this is how I do it. I have very short hair, so I'm able to just scoop it all up like that and just tuck it over my ears, slide it back to where my natural hairline is, and then I just take the top, take a little safety pin, not safety pin, don't use a safety pin, a bobby pin, and just pin the top like so. So now I'm extremely scalped. Oh no, I'm not. This tiny bit of hair has escaped. Just tuck that in there. It's quite good at this stage, especially if you do have shorter hair or you have flyaways, to like take hairspray and just go all over, just so that it kind of keeps everything up and away. So now that the wig cap is on, I'm going to use a primer. Now I'm using quite an old primer. It's a Revolution Pore Blur Primer. I just find it works for my skin tone, like my skin type, because I have quite oily skin. So I need something to kind of mattify the base before we start with anything else. So we're just gonna pop that on. Not huge amounts, just, you know, enough to be able to give you a good canvas. I feel like it's worth saying at this point that I sound like I know what I'm talking about, but I am not a makeup artist. I would not call myself a beauty guru. I've been cosplaying for nearly 10 years, so I've picked up certain tips and tricks, and again, all of this is stuff that really works for my face and my skin, so you might find that something different works for you, so just experiment, you know. Maybe I'll show some pictures here of some of my early cosplay makeup, which consisted just of a very pale foundation and mascara. Not a great look, really. Okay, so next I'm gonna do a tiny little bit of concealer on areas where I have spots, because I'm unfortunately a very spotty lady. I really wish I could tell you teenagers out there that your spots go away when you hit 18. They don't. So I'm just gonna take some of this, cover up the spots, and then blend them in with a brush. So I'm using this brush. No reason, just works. It just works. So usually what I used to do was I would just now move on to my foundation and my base. I'm actually gonna start with the infamous blue eyeshadow. And the reason for this is because I pack a lot of it on and it all ends up down here. And so if I'm not wearing any, I know we've just put concealer on, but other than that, I'm not wearing anything underneath. So if it gets everywhere, I can just wipe it off and then we can do the base and you're not gonna have blue sort of smudges everywhere. So now we're gonna do Chloe's iconic blue eyeshadow look, which I have to say, I do really love. It's great. It's just so over the top and like ridiculous. I love it. I also think it's great character design, because definitely when I was a teenager, I used to wear bright blue eyeshadow just because I was like, I used to do stage school shows and you would wear that in a stage school show. And so I thought that's what makeup was. And the eyeshadow I'm using here, it's not really a brand. It says Stargazer on the back, but honestly, this is just, I think I put into eBay like neon blue eyeshadow and this was about £1. So you can probably get this in a party shop, you can get this at a drugstore or anywhere really. It just needs to be bright. It doesn't really matter. I mean, better pigment is good, but I use so much of this that it's really not the end of the world. So we're gonna start just like packing it on to the eyes. Oh, I haven't blended, there's a bit of this I haven't blended. whoopsie, there we go. So we're just gonna start packing this like onto the eyes, and I go quite high with my eyeshadow just because I have, as you can see, quite lidded eyelids. So sadly, I don't have all that room that beauty gurus have. So here we go. I'm using quite a pointy brush just because then it helps me like draw in the shape of it. I'm probably gonna say this quite a lot throughout this video, but like this makeup isn't necessarily the most like accurate, but it's what I have, like my Chloe makeup has been involved, like I've been cosplaying Chloe for 4 years now. So my makeup has kind of changed and evolved with my skill and with like the products that I'm able to use, and also just like finding it, like, so for example, knowing that I need to take it all the way up here so that it can actually be seen and be kind of bright and big. I used to just do it here and it would disappear. Okay, so we've got the shape. Now I'm basically just gonna go over it like a few times with this color, just to kind of get it as bright as possible and make sure that there's as little skin coming through as possible. And then we'll attack it with another shade. Don't you worry, there's three shades of blue involved in this. Okay, so I'm pretty happy with this as a base. So we're gonna move on and kind of like make it more interesting. I mean, this is pretty much, I could just carry on now and this would be fine, but why do that when you can add some sparkle? So I'm gonna add, I've got this palette here from Juvia's Place. Just a quick note, none of this is sponsored, but you know, these are just great products that I like. So this palette from Juvia's Place, it's called the Zulu, and it's a great palette. I mean, look at that, that is pretty tasty. But I'm gonna be using this sparkly blue shade over here just to go over it again. And give it just a bit of shine, just because obviously the blue I used is a matte. I wanna add some sparkle to it because with cosplay, I feel like especially now, people do really interesting stuff with their makeup and you kind of don't have to just stick to what that character looks like in the show. Like you can add some highlight, you can add like big lashes, you can change the lip color, and it really doesn't matter as long as you're still kind of getting over the essence of that character. And I feel like Chloe would love a little sparkle, so here we go.
Where's my brush?
There was a, I think in Ladybug Hogwarts, I think there are a couple of shots where you can see a blue smudge on my forehead. Oh, you know what else we can see on my forehead? Unblended concealer. We love to see it. That's good. Yeah, there's a couple of shots in Ladybug Hogwarts where I just have blue on my forehead and I literally don't know where it came from. Like, I don't know how I managed to get blue eyeshadow on my forehead, but you know, be like that sometimes. So yeah, I'm just kind of going over exactly the same shape to, yeah, just make it like, I mean, look at that, look at that. I feel like this is now, this is popping. This is quiet. Okay, so there is our improved blue eyeshadow, but we're not done yet. No, we're not. So this is a recent addition to my makeup. I'm just gonna take this very dark blue and just pop it in the corners just to give it a little bit of depth. I think also this is very much down to what does your eye look like, because I definitely find that I definitely find that my eyes need a bit of darker color in the corner, because otherwise I just don't know, it brings some shape to it. I feel it makes my eyes look bigger and it's nice, I like it. I might look at, I mean, I've literally only done this a couple of times, so I might look back on this and be like, why did I do that? So I'm just gonna blend that in a little bit just to make sure that it's not kind of, because we still got eyeliner to come. So I'm just blending this into the corner like so. Okay, so that's the blue eyeshadow done. I'm pretty happy with it. I feel like it's popping, it's given us Miss Bourjois. It's probably worth saying at this point that, as you may have noticed, I have not done my eyebrows. Now I know that like most of the time you would probably wanna cover your eyebrows or maybe like draw over them. I have long since given up on trying to do anything like that because personally my eyebrows are very big and very thick and they are really difficult to cover. So I've embraced them. these are the brows we're having. But if you are doing this makeup and you want to cover your eyebrows and kind of like make sure that they're blonde, like the wig, then there are plenty of awesome eyebrow covering tutorials or eyebrow type tutorials that you can go and look at. So I will try and link some of those down below. Sadly, you're not gonna get an eyebrow tutorial from me. Listen, it's been 10 years, I'm not doing it, bro. But what I am gonna do is, if you are sort of going, eyebrows are not my thing, it's always worth getting like a little eyebrow spool. I don't actually know what they're called. They're like the thing on the end of a, you know, when you do your mascara, but you can get brushes like this. This was just an eyebrow brush. And you can just kind of brush your eyebrows a little bit into place, especially if you have quite unwieldy ones like me. And just make sure that they're kind of nice and neat. If you're not gonna do anything with them. I used to try and slather my eyebrows in concealer to try and lighten them a bit, but honestly, I really didn't like how it looked. The concealer kind of congeals in the eyebrows and it's just a bit nasty, you know, just big brows and proud, you know? Skipping over eyebrows, we are going to move on to eyeliner. Sadly, my eyeliner pen has long since lost its label and I don't know where it came from. Really any eyeliner you have. However, I would recommend a liquid or a pen rather than a gel, just because the amount of eye makeup you've got on, it's something precision-y that you know you can kind of like, you know that you're not gonna have to redo it. So I'm gonna do my eyeliner and I'm just going for pretty much a basic wing. So I'm just gonna do that now because this requires quite a lot of concentration. Okay, so there's my eyeliner. So I've just done a really, really simple wing on both sides. Sometimes I like take a wipe and just kind of wipe away the blue that's underneath, but to be honest today, I'm not too fussed about it. Then another thing I do is I'm gonna do the under eye, but I'm gonna do that with eyeshadow because I do not get on with liquid eyeliner. So just take any black eyeshadow. I'm using one from this lovely palette from Revolution. Doesn't matter. And I'm just gonna do like the under eye all the way around. I make the funniest faces. What is this? I look like a turtle. Look, I'm doing it again. Okay, there we go. So that is the eyeshadow bit done. It's probably worth having some wet wipes on hand just in case you need to tidy anything up. So for example, I'm just gonna tidy up the inner corners where there's just been some kind of like some leakage and then also underneath the wings. We're gonna leave the eyes for now and we're gonna come back and do eyelashes later. But what I will just do as kind of prep is I'm just gonna grab some mascara. I use the Huda or Hudda, not sure how you pronounce that. Hudda Beauty dual wielding mascara just to kind of like get rid of some of the, cause you might notice that your eyelashes will be a bit blue now. So it's just good to get a bit of mascara on them to kind of combat that. It's also good for if you're not wearing eyelashes. I would highly recommend false eyelashes for this look, just because Chloe, she is like a Paris Kardashian, and so she needs to have that kind of, like, I feel like she needs to have that big lash look. Now we're gonna move on to foundation. So I'm just gonna do my base. Now it's probably worth noting, now Chloe in the show, she has a rather orangey look to her. I don't personally recommend trying to replicate this unless your skin tone is actually that color, just because it's just not very, it's not a good look, is it? Like, let's not do that. So I'm just gonna use my everyday foundation, which is the L'Oreal Infallible Total Cover in Natural Rose. So I'm going to, now I'm putting it on my finger, but I'm not going to blend it with my finger. Don't worry, gang. So not very much. Just gonna, this is just how I do my foundation so that we get even coverage. So I'm gonna take my beauty blender, just a pretty standard beauty blender, and just, you know, get in there. It's probably worth saying at this point, if you don't like any of my makeup techniques, that I don't know what to tell you, like, this is just how I do it, innit? And make sure to blend down into your neck as well. It's always a good idea, no matter how good a match your foundation is, it's always a,
a good idea to blend lower than you need to.
It's also quite funny because I'm a very, very freckly person. Not right now, like, now I've actually got quite a few freckles, but during the summer, oh my goodness, like, no foundation can keep them hidden. My base is done. Gonna do some contour. Not huge amounts. This is actually just for me, personal preference, just because I don't, like, I don't feel that I, my, in the face, I don't feel I look that much like Chloe. I mean, she is like a cartoon character, so I guess nobody really looks like her, but I don't feel like in the face I look like her. So I'm, instead of, you could do some sort of transformative contouring, but I'ma be real with you, I don't know how to do that. So I'm just gonna do my kind of basic contouring just to give me a bit more structure to my face. So I usually do just the cheekbones. Do a little bit under my nose. I don't know why. I think I picked that up from somewhere at some point and I don't really know that it does anything. I just like doing it. And then for me as well, I just feel like I don't, like I like defining the jawline a bit more. So just doing kind of a little bit, and make sure you blend this for goodness sakes. Like, this is not one that you don't want to be blended. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna take some powder. I'm using the Rimmel Stay Matte and just gonna kind of blend that in so that it's not too pronounced. And you're also setting a foundation. Now I actually find, because I use matte foundations, I don't actually use a lot of setting powder anymore, despite the fact that at the beginning of this I said that I had oily skin, which indicates I really should use setting powder. All right, so the next bit is one of my favorite parts of this look, is the blusher. So Chloe has this quite pronounced, like, pink blush that to me doesn't look very blended at all. Like, it's really, like, whenever I look at it, I always feel like it's really high up on her face because it kind of gives her this strange, like, high cheekbones look. So I'm using the Sleek Makeup blush in Flamingo, which is this absolutely insane neon pink, which I adore for Chloe. And actually, it's funny, when I got this, I was like, I'm only ever gonna use this for Chloe. This is a ridiculous color. But honestly, I actually really like this color. Like, I've cosplaying Chloe so much, has made me really appreciate pink blush and blue eyeshadow. So I'm gonna take quite a lot of this and just literally go about kind of here, kind of where you'd put your highlight, and just like draw like a little circle like that. It is gonna look ridiculous, but that's sort of part of it. If you don't look a little bit like a clown, are you really cosplaying Chloe Bourgeois? This side as well, just, it really, okay, maybe I've gone a little overboard with it today, but fret not, we aren't gonna blend it. So then you take a different brush. So I just, honestly, I don't know what, but I don't know where this brush even came from. It's just a blush brush, in it. I'm gonna use, this is a Real Techniques. Well, it was Once Upon a Time, but it's quite an old brush. It's just sort of a blending brush, and I'm just gonna kind of, in circular motions, blend this up a bit onto my cheekbones. So it should still be really pronounced, but less like a kind of a doll. So I'm just gonna blend this out. Okay, this was maybe too much today. This was maybe too much, but sometimes you just gotta roll with it, you know? You can blend it further in, you can put stuff on your nose, it's up to you, but as long as you've got that kind of ridiculous pink blush, then I think we're Gucci. Well, we're not Gucci, but we're Chloe. We're bourgeoisie. So I'm just gonna take a bit of highlighter. I'm using I didn't say what palette I use for contour. I'm using the Revolution Ultra Contour Powder Palette, which is really great. I mean, a lot of these brands are UK drugstore brands because that's where I shop. If you're in the UK, they're very affordable and they are easy to get hold of. So I would recommend. I'm just gonna put like a tiny bit of highlighter on my Cupid's bow. And then just a little bit above the blush. And with highlighter as well, like, something I have found is that I used to like religiously follow where people online put their highlighter, and I was like, yeah, I've got to put it in exactly the same place. Don't do that, because you might be putting it in places that actually will be unflattering to your face. I found that definitely, like, people often put it here, and for me personally, this is not a good place to put it, but here is. So I think just have a look at your face in the light and see where light kind of naturally bounces off your face and put the highlighter there instead. So like, I like having a tiny bit on my nose
And then I like to put it underneath, like on my brow bone here, just to kind of, I don't know, just, I like it. I can't explain it. But Cupid's bow is a fave for me.
Right, okay, it is now time to go and put my wig on, and then I'm gonna do my lips, and then I'm going to do my eyelashes to finish off kind of the whole look. It's also worth pointing out, I'm also gonna go and get changed into my Chloe like top and cardigan and costume. It's quite a good idea to do your makeup in something that is not your costume, just in case there is a terrible accident and you spill blue eyeshadow all over everything. It's up to you, but I've been doing it in this nice 86th floor t-shirt that is available from our Teespring store. This is a Bendy and the Ink Machine inspired t-shirt, and you can buy that on hoodies and mugs and t-shirts and everything, and the link to that is up here. So I'm gonna go and put my wig on and I will see you in a moment. So there we go, wig is all on. I'm sorry that I didn't show you the wig on camera. I am not a wig stylist by any means. My advice for people wanting to cosplay Chloe that don't have a wig yet, just get a ponytail wig. Don't, like, I tried to be like special and different. Like, I had a wig that was really big for a bit. This wig is too small, I need to get a clip on. It's a whole story, you don't need to hear it. What I will say though is this wig is a lace front that I don't glue down ever because I can't be bothered. But you know, there are lots of different wigs out there. Chloe's hair is difficult because it is scraped back in a ponytail. That is quite a tough one to do, but I'll drop some links below for like wigs from different sites that I would recommend, and that might give you a good starting point. It's time to do the last two bits of this makeup look, which of course includes the lipstick. So this is probably the bougiest makeup product I have in this lineup. For Chloe, I use a MAC satin lipstick in the shade Pink Nouveau, which is this gorgeous bright pink shade. Okay, it's definitely worth saying here that this is not Chloe's canon lipstick shade. Her lipstick shade is just kind of concealer. Like, it is like, it's like the chav makeup you see on TikTok. I did try that for ages. I just hated how it looked. It just made it look like I wasn't wearing any lipstick. I don't have particularly big lips anyway, so they just disappeared into my face. It really wasn't for me, so I have decided to go the bright pink route. So I would really encourage you to find a lipstick shade that works for you rather than trying to do what she wears in the show. If that suits you, then good for you. Like, I wish that were me. God, I wish that were me. If you watch all the various different Ladybug CMVs that we've made over the years, you can see like my lipstick is like a different color in every single one. And I think in the Hogwarts one, I just wore red lipstick because I don't know, like I literally was like, I don't know what color lip I want to wear anymore. That is the lipstick. And now it's time for eyelashes. Now I'm probably going to do these off camera because eyelashes, mate, like I can't. But what I will share with you is the eyelashes I use, which are these. And that is the complete look. So this is my Chloe Bourgeois from Miraculous Ladybug cosplay makeup look. I really hope you enjoyed this video and I hope that you found it helpful, or if not helpful, at least entertaining. Let me know in the comments if there's any questions you have about anything I did in this tutorial, and I will try my best to answer them for you. If you do use this tutorial as a way to do your Chloe makeup, please, please tag me in it. You can tag me personally at Hilda Glitz, or you can tag the 86th Floor accounts, which are here. I would really love to see your Chloe looks because not enough people cosplay Chloe in this world. That is all from me. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we upload new videos. Give this video a big thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next episode. Bye!